So it's Saturday morning again, 6 a.m. Start of my day. Let's get this boat sorted. So we arrive at the boat yard a little bit later than expected, but at least we're here. There she is. There I am. We're going up. And look at this, the engine is waiting for me. So the gentleman in the crane here during the week managed to put this in. Perfect. Well, next video should be me showing you the engine and hopefully seeing how we can get it in. So we're inside. She's looking a lot brighter, apart from the front bit, but that's not done the V-berth yet. But she's getting there, isn't she? As you can see, that's got a bit of top gloss on. This one hasn't, so you can see the shine difference, see? We're slowly getting there. And that's what it was in the first place. Well, it was even worse than that before. Alright. Let's get myself set up. Anyone recognise the t-shirt? The Tajir Spirit, guys. Oh. Right, lesson learnt from doing the engine. Don't do it on yourself next time. It's one of the hardest things I've done ever. But we got it in. But lifting that and moving that on your own is quite hard. Mainly because it's a small space. But now we have it in. I don't have the engine mount yet, so I've just rested it on something. Blocks of wood. You can see here, I'm lucky that I can just move that down a slight bit and it will fit on the pot, or on the shaft. So we're lucky that way. But I'll still have to get some proper engine mounts. We need proper engine mounts. At the minute, you can see a piece of wood. I don't even know what that is. It's like a resin block. I've got one engine mount over here at the moment. But now, so now it's about getting the exhaust back on as well. Seeing if I can get it at the right angle so it'll fit. And see how this seawater exhaust works. It's all new. We get there. Alright, so remember when I said I needed a main sander? Boom! Made sure I got one big enough. And it works. It's always a bonus. So now, it's time to get on with sanding. Right, rather than you watching me do it all, I'll give it a quick time lapse and you can see how it goes. the roller, got the paint, already started. I've been doing light rolls with this, just to try and do a thin coat. Do about two or three thin coats. I got a really good roller and a long stick, makes it easier for me. And I'm not bending down all the time picking the paint up. But I've done the back, starting on the side. Then we can have a see. Takes a few hours to dry. Maybe get another coat on later on today. Come back tomorrow and should look quite good. Getting there slowly, surely, but it's looking better already. First coat done, a couple more to go yet, but we'll leave that, let it dry, and I'll maybe use some on the top as well. Now get it primed up while I can, while it's dry. Ready? This is the paint I'm using, by the way, if anybody's interested. Ample Primer Undercoat. No idea about it, it's just that's what they had in the store. So I bought it. Oh, we've got somebody coming in. I think that's the engineer guy. Alright, see you. I put a second coat on. It dries quite fast with it rolling, because just get it tacky and then stick the second one on. Keep showing you, So, looking good. Into this, I'm gonna have to get that to a different colour. Definitely looking better already. Notice some little lights just at the top there as well. I've got on the running lights. It changes the air. We get there slowly and surely. So Saturday, I'll call it a night. It's at 5:30 in the evening. It's starting to get a little bit dark. But I just thought I'd show you the view that you get from here. Looks quite light, but it's just getting ready to go dark. Load of ducks in the middle there. It's a bit boggy here, but it's coming up to high tide, so the tide's all coming in. So it comes just short of here. Big anchor in the way there. If you watched Commander Dots before, this is where he flew over with the drone, and you can see everything. And a raven has to say hello, doesn't it? I think Mr. Miyagi's been here. It's not a bad view you get, really. The boatyard. Right. Food time, or food and beer. Now what do we get? Chinese and beer, you can't go wrong with that. Alright, see you in a bit. So, I've sanded this, pre-sanded it, but just lightly with my little orbit sander. As I found on the other side, when I used the big sander, it was too bumpy, too aggressive, really. And I found that out after I painted, I could see all the bumps with it. So I'm going to have to re-sand the other side after I've put a bit more paint on to try and smooth it out. Now, I'm going to put the undercoat on this one. So, like I say, Got my sailing yabber. I don't know if you've heard of these. I've been watching them on YouTube. You get a lot of information while they're doing those as well. So search sailing yabber on YouTube as well if you want. I bought a t-shirt off them. They look pretty cool. Something on the back. But anyway, back to the painting and I'll time lapse it for you. It's snack time. Needed this. Been a while. Had a sandwich for breakfast. And now what time is it? 5:10. I get my lunch. Pepperami! Can't go wrong with them. So yeah, I'm definitely not vegetarian, am I? But so we got quite a lot of the boat done. We did the painting on the outside, undercoats, and I've also put one top coat on ready of the gloss. I'll need a couple of layers of that on, and then I'll sand it down a bit, polish it up, try and make it look really shiny. Well, that's the idea. We'll see if it works. I also got the engine inside the engine bay. That was quite hard on me own. But you'll, I bet you enjoyed watching that on a time lapse. It was a good job really, because you'd have heard me swear a lot probably. But we got there and we did it. Now, homeward bound, back to north, as they say. See you in a bit.